What if I told you there is a .NET MAUI functionality that I didn't even know about? I know, right? But I found out about it now, and I'm going to share it with you just because I'm such a nice guy, so please follow me into this video. Under my video about how to generate barcodes inside of your .NET MAUI application with ZXing, there was this comment by Geert, and I suspect he is a fellow Dutchman, where he asks, like, hey, how can I export this barcode to an image, which is probably something that you want to do, right? And I was checking it out for him, and I was looking at, like, can I do this with the ZXing plugin? And it turns out that you don't really can't. But then I found this CaptureAsync method, which sounds very interesting. And this CaptureAsync method, you can apply that to any view, so basically any visual element inside of your .NET MAUI application. That means that you can take a screenshot of basically any slice of your application, whether that be just a button, the whole stack layout, the whole screen, or a drawing view to capture a signature, although the drawing view in the .NET MAUI community toolkit already has functionality to get the stream and the image data out of there, but regardless, you can use this as well, and you can export that barcode that you've generated with the ZXing library. So let's go check out how to actually use it so that you can now export all the things from your .NET MAUI application as an image. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a file, new .NET MAUI project, and this is built inside of .NET MAUI itself, so no need for extra dependencies or plugins or whatnot. You can just do this with .NET MAUI. Now, let's go to the code behind from our main page, and inside of this counter clicked, I'm just going to remove this code here for now. And what you can do, actually, I think the button in here has a name, right? So let's scroll down, counter button. So let's take that and do dot. And here we can see all the APIs, all the properties, all the methods that you can do on it. But we also have capture async. You can see that right here. It's an extension, right? So it's an extension method, and it returns a iScreenshot result. And that gave me a hint, like, hey, okay, this is interesting. I can take a screenshot with this. So we can do capture async. Let's just do that. I need to make this async then, and we want to capture that result. So let's say result is await, and now we have that screenshot result, right? So let's see what we can do with that. And we can see the width, the height, we can open read async, or we can copy it to another stream if that's what we want. And you can see that here in the parameters for that, we have to point it to a stream destination, which makes sense. But we can also say, like, hey, this should be a format of PNG, and I think the other option is a JPEG. And you can do something with the quality so that it compresses the image if that's what you want as well. And that's about it, right? But that's about it. This is really powerful stuff that's just hidden away here in .NET MAUI. Who knew? But so let's see what we can do. And I just want to save it to a file for now. So actually, let me just copy in some code that I've written before to actually do this, so you don't have to watch me write all the code here. So what I'm going to do here, actually, I see this code is a little bit funny. So what I'm going to do is here, say this, I'm going to capture the stream. So I'm going to say open read async. But what I can actually do, because here I'm going to do copy async, and I can skip this altogether because the copy was already here in this result, right? So I can just do this, and I can actually here just remove this and say result.copy to async, and then say that memory stream, right? So we can do that as well. That saves us some lines of code, which is always good. And then here I'm going to just write this to my desktop folder and then say button.png, right? So I'm going to do the button for now. Of course, you don't want to do this path because this path is not going to work on iOS or Android, but I'm just going to show you on Windows for now. For iOS and Android, you probably want to use kind of like the built-in path and file static classes to get a nice path there. If you want to know more about that, please let me know down in the comments and I'll make a video on that. So if I run this on Windows, then now whenever I click the button, it should take a screenshot. Is that really a screenshot? I don't know. But it at least, you know, captures the button and saves that to an image for us, which is pretty amazing if you ask me. So waiting for the app to come up here. And whenever I click this here, then we don't see anything happening here visually. But if I go to my file explorer and to the desktop, then you can now see that I have this button click me right here, button.png. Here it is. it just saves it for me. So that's pretty cool. Now I'm going to delete this and I'm going to make it a little bit more interesting. So what happens if we do this for like the entire kind of like stack layout here, right? So I'm going to give this an X name is stack, just name it something. And I'm going to change this counter button right here. So stack. And of course the file name, very important, stack.png. And whenever I do this now, what I expect is that the whole stack layout is going to be captured, right? It's going to have this image, it's going to have this label, it's going to have the button, it's going to have everything in here in a nice image. I just clicked it, and here we are. So one weird thing, well, it's not really weird, it's kind of like explainable, right? Is that it has a black background, which is probably because it's transparent, because we don't really set the background here implicitly, right? Or explicitly, sorry. So what you probably want to do whenever you want to use this for some scenario that you have in mind, you might want to specify the background for like this vertical stack layout. So let's make this a background color white, and I suspect that then it will come up with a white background. So that's something that you need to take into account. By default, it seems that it doesn't really take a background color, which is something that, you know, that makes sense because we didn't specify one. But whenever you do want to have one and you want it to look nice for your user, then you probably want to specify one here. See, so now we have this white background and we have this all the image and the labels and the buttons right here, just as they appear on screen, right? So that is pretty cool. You can just capture any piece of UI in your .NET MAUI app with this capture async method that's just hidden away in plain sight here in .NET MAUI. So one of the other cool things that you can do here, I already named a few, like, you know, export that barcode, export that drawing view signature, if that's what you want. But what you can also do with this, I made a video on App Center the other day. It should pop up on your screen right now. Go check that out. You could attach screenshots to your crash reports in App Center, right? You can capture a screenshot with this, attach it to your App Center crash report, send that back to App Center, and you have all the data from your user about why your app crashes. Of course, you write apps that don't crash, right? But that's beyond the point here. You will get that screenshot and you can get all the information from your user. How cool is that? If you've liked this video, please press the like button. And actually, I mentioned the Geert person here in the beginning, and he is a member of this channel. So if you want to become a member, if that's something that might be interesting to you and support me a little bit in this YouTube journey, go check out the join button down below and see what it all entails. Please subscribe to my channel. That's something that you can always do for free because all the content will be free forever. No need to join if that's what you want. Definitely do that. And I'll be seeing you for my next video, but not before I point you to this playlist right here, which has more .NET MAUI videos. This special video that is recommended just for you. I searched the whole YouTubes. This is the best video for you right now. And check out this button if you're actually subscribed. See you for the next one.